Well, ladies and gentlemen, we are on scale 3.4 full blown, which is the geometry scale of equations of parallel and perpendicular lines. All right, key points. Parallel lines have the same slope. So for instance, if my M is 5, my parallel slope is also equal to 5. And this symbol means parallel to. And then perpendicular lines have opposite reciprocal slopes. So what that means is if my original slope is 2/3, my perpendicular slope is, I'm gonna flip over the 2/3 and make it 3/2, and then I'm gonna change the sign. So -3/2. Or if I had -4/5, I could say then that my perpendicular slope would be, I'm just gonna flip it. And the opposite of a negative is a positive. All right, one thing that you'll definitely need to have from the last skill are the different forms of equations. So here they are, point slope form. This is your y minus y1 equals to m times x minus x1, where x1 comma y1 is a point and m is a slope. My slope intercept form, that's y equals to mx plus b, where m is your slope and b is conveniently your y intercept. And then your standard form is ax plus by equals c. And you want to convert a standard form into slope intercept form by solving for y. So this is basically the roadmap that you need to do well with equations of parallel and perpendicular lines. So please make sure that you have this chart down, that it's clear in your notes. All right, the first type of problem is write the equation that represents the perpendicular line to this equation here. So you want, this is in standard form. So you wanna make sure that you are converting to y equals mx plus b. So if I have x minus 2y equals to -14, let me just circle that y that I want to get by itself. So I'm going to move the x over to the other side. So I have -2y equals to -x minus 14. And then I'm just going to divide by -2. Everything. So I have y equals to, and then this is a 1, a -1/-2. So that's 1/2 x + 7. Sorry about that. That is a +7. So our slope is 1/2. So we want our perpendicular slope to be the reciprocal of 1/2. So I'm gonna write that as 2/1, and I'm gonna put a negative sign. And there is only one situation in which that occurs. And that would be not with the 1/2 or the +2, but But that would be in this situation right there. All right, let's look at another type of example that you're going to see. This says the lines represented by the equation. It's a little variation to what we had in the last problem, except now you are going to be comparing. You want them to be in slope-intercept form. So this is good. Now this one, I'm just going to move the 3x over to the other side. So I have y equals to 3x plus 5. And I'm just going to like look at my slopes. So this one has an m of 3. This one has an m of 3. They have the same slope. And guess what has the same slope? Parallel. So if you get like reciprocals that are like not opposite, that would be like neither parallel nor perpendicular. If you had opposite reciprocal, you know, that would be perpendicular. All right, this one, this says write an equation of a line that passes through the point. -2, -3, so I'm gonna put x1, y1. And it's parallel to this line. So I'm just going to kind of keep track here. So I have my equation y minus y1. This is a point slope 1. And that equals to m times x minus x1. So my x1 is equal to -2. My y1 is equal to -3. And my M, I do not know yet, but I can find it here. So I'm gonna have, I want this negative Y by itself. I'm gonna write negative Y equals to -4X plus 1. And then I'm just gonna divide by -1. So I get y equals to 4x minus 1. So our slope is 4. And our parallel slope is also equal to 4. So the first thing that we did here is we converted to y equals mx plus b. To find slope of the original line. So now we have enough information. So these are my things here. And then I'm just going to plug it in. So I have y minus -3 equals to m, which is 4. And I have x minus -2. And I'm just going to make them into positive signs since I have the double negatives. And like that, I have a legitimate equation of a line that is parallel. All right, let's see another one. We want this one to be perpendicular. So same thing here. So first you want to convert equation into y equals mx plus b. For the original line. So what that means is I'm gonna do x plus 6y equals 6. I wanna get y by itself, so I have 6y equals to negative x plus 6. Divide by 6 on all sides. So I have y equals to -1/6x plus 1. My point, so, and then use point slope form. So my M is -1/6. And then my perpendicular slope would be 6/1, and that would be positive. And then here's my x1 and y1. So I'm gonna write x1 equals to -1, y1 equals to -6, and then your m is equal to 6. And I'm just gonna write y minus y1 equals to m times x minus x1. So I'm gonna write y minus a -6 equals to 6 times x minus -1. And we are all done. So that concludes equations of parallel and perpendicular lines for you, a point.